everybody. Mr. Liquid Brett here with another beer review, and this is Squirrel Murray, straight out of the 1980s movie Hot Dog, right?
That's right.
What's your name?
Squirrel.
You missed a spot.
What, here?
So tonight we're going to do something special for all you hopheads out there and all you Bells fanatics. Whatever you want to call yourselves.
Nut jobs.
Tonight we're going to do, boom, Arcadia Hop Rocket and Bell's Hop Slam. Too much? Well, I guess we can. You grab the Arcadia. We've got neighboring cities. They're within 20 miles of each other. One is Bell's in Kalamazoo, Michigan. Arcadia Brewing Company out of Battle Creek, Michigan, the home of Kellogg's. And they're about 20 miles apart from each other. We're going to go one-on-one with these two. And so, right off the bat, what do you think about these labels?
Interesting, kind of fun, a little different on the label itself. But, you know, certainly the writing and the neck label, I think that's the same neck label they put on everything they have.
And that rocket is right out of, like, Flash Gordon era.
Oh, it totally is.
50s or something like that.
I like the bottle cap.
Yep, I like
that's,
that.
The Irish knot on there is...
Is that what that's called? An Irish knot?
Yeah.
Nice.
Absolutely. It's or maybe that's the Scottish version, but
I'd say it's just frothing out of an ocean of beer, like the
I was gonna say it looks like foam on top of a beer coming out of the back of it, and I think that's hops coming out of the engine too. See that? I never noticed.
Yeah,
that
it's the engine. Actually, I'm gonna sit this bottle down. Bell is gonna have to wait.
It's a hop fired rocket.
Yes, the bottom of the rocket is actually, the rocket engines are actually fueled by hop cones, hop flowers, I should say. That's awesome. The propulsion is greenish coming out of the back. All right, let's switch over to the old Bells. Mr. Larry Bell and Associates. I do have to say I like the Hop Slam bottle cap better. I like it.
You know what? I have to agree with you. They put that same bottle cap on every Arcadia beer, and this is specifically a Hop Slam cap.
Right.
Because it matches... The label.
It's basically, there's a guy, apparently he just got slammed, got crushed by a humongous hop flower there, just crushed him. Hop slam, get it? A biting, bitter, tongue bruiser of an ale. With a name like Hop Slam, what did you expect? From Bell's, I expected a lawsuit. That's just me. That's just me. Yes, Hop Rocket is 9 or 9.5%. Hop Slam is a flat out, big old double deuce. 10. All right, so we're going to pour both these and get to it. I like this.
Looking good.
Not going to fit.
No, it's not.
Come on here, buddy. This is the Hop Rocket. This is the Hop Slam. As you can see, the head on the Hop Rocket is not quite as pronounced and kind of died pretty quick. The head on the Hop Slam has actually retained itself pretty well. And actually, there's quite a bit of carbonation bubbles.
I was just
going to
say, there's a lot of carbonation in the glass, too.
Ugh.
And it's not just one pour, because mine are identical.
Right. I do want to point out, too, that the colors of the beers, the Hop Rocket is a little more amber than the Hop Slam. The Hop Rocket has more of an amber, not quite a red ale, where the Hop Slam is more of a dark straw color. Let's blast off with the Rocket.
All right, Rocket it is.
Salute.
You smell it first?
Oh, I do that normally when I'm sober.
When you haven't been drunk. You're never sober on these things.
No. I'm not getting much of an aroma.
It's a minimal fruity.
I've got a little bit of fruit notes. Smooth.
Yep. Kind of an ester front.
Yep.
Taste. That's the first time I've had it in the bottle, and it's very similar to the...
You are privileged to have it out right from the mother's
prime.
Team.
Yes.
Yes, I do get a little bit of a lemon zest off this, a little bit. Take a little sip, I get a little, that's that little zing I get, a little bit of a zing taste you get.
I can see that. Yeah.
Maybe absolutely. A little bit of a grassy note, but very subtle.
Yeah, I think they're stretching with the mushroom description.
Yeah. Yeah, Arcadia Brewing Company has a description of this beer, and they note that wild mushrooms is one of the tastes. That is not appealing to me in a beer at all. No. Wild mushrooms. Unless I'm eating wild mushrooms with my beer, that would be good. Like some morales or something.
Or maybe beer over a steak might
yeah,
be.
Yeah, yeah, but not in my beer. Unless I barfed in it after eating. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. And that's really an appetizing.
Yeah,
so.
No.
Let's switch lanes and go over to the asshole side of the brewing world here.
I thought we were being objective tonight.
Well, I'm trying to be objective, but whenever I see the word Bells, I just don't get real positive. All right, so here we've got the Bells Hopslam. You get more of an aroma off this, more of a floral, almost a little bit of a hint of grapefruit. Yeah, I can see where this beer sneaks up on certain people because it's definitely got a low vinous or alcohol note to it, so it doesn't really sneak up to you. So, it does sneak up to you because you don't taste that alcohol.
Think you're drinking 10%.
Right. Bell says this beer tastes like stone fruit,
and I've never heard of stone fruit.
No. Maybe in a Harry Potter movie, but I
heard ugly fruit.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? I've heard of star fruit.
Star fruit, that's another one?
Stone fruit.
Never heard of that.
This beer's got more of a meaty texture, or a more heavy flavor on the tongue or the mouth in general. I'm gonna switch lanes again.
Side by side, it's interesting because as you taste the Hopslam, it's you certainly don't get you notice the alcohol flavor of the hop rocket more so side by side, and the actual malt of the beer and the Hopslam that I think the hop rocket is covering with their alcohol flavor.
You're like,
Jesus Christ.
Top off! You always gotta top off.
Here we go. Top off. Don't leave anything in the bottle.
Does Hopslam taste better when you drink a shittier beer?
I don't know. I think that's kind of a loaded question. What's the shittier beer?
Hop Rocket.
You know?
The labels are pretty much a draw to me. They both have unique characteristics. The Hopslam cap, they're both fun.
Hopslam cap definitely gives it.
Hopslam throws it over the edge. Plus, the Hopslam has got a back label. You know, it's kind of like a tramp stamp.
Look. Here's a really cool lower back tattoo on an attractive 20-year-old girl. Now watch what happens to that tattoo when that young girl becomes a 65-year-old woman. Pretty sad indeed.
I was going to say a back tattoo, but call it what you will.
Tramp stamp for beer.
Tramp stamp,
a tramp stamp on the back of the back label, so. You're drinking Hopslam. I don't think it's the best Imperial IPA I've ever had.
No.
Again, it doesn't have a lot of that spectrum of character with the hop notes.
No. Yeah, there's not a lot of depth to it. The honey that they put in, really, there's no honey flavor in there.
No.
There's not even a hint of honey in there.
I'm drunk! How many times does it get to my liver? One. How many licks does it take?
One.
Two. In there.
Three licks.
Let's see how many shots it takes to kill a dumbass owl. One, two, three. There we go. Want to be a dumbass? You got it.
All right, so you know here on Mr. Liquid Bread, this is how we roll. Get your roll on.
What the fuck? Hold on. Everybody, get your roll on.
Everybody, get your roll on.
Let's do one. Take a breath.
Up top to bottom. These go down smooth.
Drink it down.
Bottoms up.
Bottoms up, top to bottom, whatever you want to say.
The Hopslam does have more of a character than the Hop Rocket, unfortunately. There's the winner right there, folks. Unfortunately, I have to say,
side by side,
Bells is one.
Whip your terrible towel around.
I hate to mess up your...
But anyways, this again, this is the Arcadia Hop Rocket versus Hell.
Still a good beer.
See ya. Yeah!